Spectrum hacks in 5 minutes. Let's go!
Number one, find the right samples fast. You might prefer working with audio samples, and we'll get to that in part two, but the biggest advantage to working with drums and MIDI is the ability to quickly try out different samples, simply drag a new sample onto your drum pad and the sound of the whole MIDI clip changes. Number two, create separate track lanes for each MIDI drum pad. In spite of tip one, many people still prefer working with audio samples because they want to process the different samples in separate audio lanes, but you can do this too with MIDI drums. Simply create a new track lane for each individual drum pad. When you create a new track, for the input, choose the name of the track that holds your drum pad, so for me it's called 30 Drum Rack. For the channel, choose the specific drum pad you want to edit, so for me it's my snare. And now you can mute the snare in your original drum pad and edit everything about the snare in this new audio lane that you created. Just make sure to set your monitoring to in. Now you can automate volume, panning, and your devices for each drum sample on a separate lane. Number three, add variation to your hi-hats. This is one of my personal favorites. You can add variation to your hi-hats by transposing separate samples, changing the volume or velocity, the panning, or adding delay. Getting movement in the highs creates excellent contrast to a steady low end in the drums, like the kick, and can turn your track from average to really, really exciting. Number four, add ghost notes. If your beat still feels a bit stagnant, try adding some ghost notes. Take your existing kick sample and make it softer. You can even detune it a few cents down. Place it just before some of the existing kicks and voila! This, musically, adds a little skip in your step and helps drive the beat forward. This works on hats and snares too, by the way. Number five, record in some of your drums. One way to make your MIDI drums have feeling is, well, to program them with feeling. No matter how much feeling you put into clicking with the pen tool, that's not going to translate into your music. And even if you suck at recording drums, just pick one. Here I'm taking out the snare and recording only the snare hits. You don't need any fancy equipment for this, you can just record them with your computer keyboard.
So guys, let me know which of these tips helped you the most, and let's smash that like button and try and get it to 1,000. If we do that, I'm gonna choose a random comment telling me what to do, and I'm gonna do that thing. If you wanna see part two for this series, hit that subscribe button, share this with your friends, and I'll see you soon in the next one.